Okay, like many of you, I'm sure you've had the problem, unless you run your Gibbs way too freaking tight, but if you got them properly adjusted, yeah, and your Z, if you raise your Z up, turn the power off, you have a problem with the head dropping down. That can be a problem if you got a bit in there or part on there and you don't want it crashing into the table. So a little solution is my power switch for my drivers. It's a double pole, double throw switch. So when it's on, one side is providing power to the power supply. But when it's off, the other two legs on the other pole are shorting out the A plus and A minus lugs of my Z-axis stepper motor plug. I got it into the back, so I'm just shorting out the A plus and the A minus. You could do B plus, B minus if you wanted, but you only need to short out one coil. So when you take power off, you can do an experiment on the table. When no wires are connected, you can spin it easy, but if you connect one of the coils, it gets harder to move, so that's enough to keep the head from dropping. See, I'm gonna move it up. Now this switch has a middle position where it's neither on nor off, so it would show it dropping, but I put it in the off position, shorted out that coil, and it stopped. Works pretty good. See, works every time. Put it in the middle, shows it's normally dropping, shut it off. But of course, normally, just completely shut off and it goes nowhere. Problem solved. Now, I've read about people using relays to basically do the same thing. You apply power to the relay and it'll, you know, use the normally closed contacts. So when power's off, to like your drivers, that's why I got this one. It's a 48 volt. So the idea was when the power's off to the drivers, it would the normally closed lugs would short out the A plus and A minus on the stepper. But I just use the easier double pole, double throw switch. Works nice.